Do you still remember the Wan Animate model? That is right. It is the model that can perfectly replace character roles. Now, the second version has been released. The VT version offers three significant improvements compared to the previous version. First, the replication of movements is more perfect. Second, the sampling speed is faster. Third, it effectively reduces the occurrence of blur. Okay, next we will detail this model. You can open Kijai's repository on Hugging Face. We can see a Wan Animate folder here. Let's click into it. About 3 days ago, a new model was released. This model is called Wan Animate VC. Note that this version is actually slightly smaller than the first version. Therefore, its sampling speed will also be faster. Similarly, you can open Kijai's Wan video extension and click on the example workflow. You can see there is a new example workflow related to the Wan Animate model here. What improvements and enhancements have been made to this workflow? Next, we will provide a detailed analysis. I have also built the workflow on Running Hub. You can visit this platform via runninghub.ai. In the ComfyUI domain, Running Hub is an excellent online working platform because whenever new technologies and extensions emerge, Running Hub follows up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description, which grants you 1,000 free points. Furthermore, logging into Running Hub daily will give you 100 bonus points. This allows you to try out your own workflows. When we import Kijai's workflow, it looks roughly like this. Let's examine where the improvements lie. First, let's look at the main model loading section. I am loading the Wan Animate VC model provided by Kijai here. Similar to the first version, we need to download a Relight LoRA here. We also need to download an accelerating light x-liang for the LoRA. I am using a weight of 1.0 for these, which might slightly differ from Kijai's official settings. Next, we need to load the VAE. The text encoder is loaded within this node. Additionally, we have our clip vision. Regarding the download of the main model, you can see there is a download list here. If you are unsure where to download it, you can directly download the corresponding model using this link. Aside from the changes to the main model, there are no major improvements elsewhere in this section. Next is the video processing section, which is the part of the entire workflow with the most significant changes. First, we set the resolution, which is 832x480小时, a year. Then, we load a video. Note that this video features a beautiful woman with rich movements and facial expressions. This video is mainly used to test the improvements of the Wan Animate VC version regarding facial expression and motion transfer. As we mentioned earlier, Kijai made a relatively major improvement in this section. Primarily, the step where we previously manually selected the mask has been changed to automatic selection. Here, we will use a new extension called Wan Animate Preprocessor. You can visit its GitHub homepage using this link. The main focus here is the implementation of highly useful nodes for automatic mask generation. First, there is our pose and face detection, meaning we are now detecting the person's face and body. Previously, we used the pose editor, using red and green dots to manually select the most crucial areas, and then finally determine the mask we needed. That process was relatively complicated. Therefore, an automated process has been implemented here. We will use many models in this section. So, there is a model loader here. Note that this model loader uses the ONNX format for loading. Regarding the download of all the models used here, you can refer to this Node.ui documentation. The download addresses for each model are provided. We use YOLO and VT pose. One is for detecting the face, and the other is for detecting the entire body. Next, the image we want to detect, including its width and height, is input. This first detects the pose data and our facial data. The facial data can be extracted directly, which is the part you see now. The pose data requires further processing. Thus, a node called drawVidPose is used. This node essentially uses the standard VidPose to draw it onto our canvas. The final result is the effect you see now. You should note that this is different from DW OpenPose. It does not provide precise facial information. Then, we can use a node like SegmentAnything to extract our mask. Similarly, we will use the corresponding model here. We expand the mask by 10 pixels and then draw into our image area. You can see the blocky mask form we saw earlier. The sampling section does not differ much from the original. Note that we need a reference image here, which is this section. It is a Western beauty, which we scale to the required resolution according to our specifications. Using our clip vision, the visual model, we encode it and pass it to this node. This node is the most critical node for Wan Animate. This node is not significantly different from the first version, so I won't elaborate here. What you need to pay attention to is that it uses a sliding window mechanism. Therefore, note that the frame length I initially loaded is quite large, 180 frames, and the size of this sliding window here is 77 frames. Therefore, it will undergo multiple sliding samples to achieve the final result. As we mentioned just now, here is a text prompt. The prompt section is not particularly important here. I kept it very simple, a beautiful woman's high definition video. Then we proceed with sampling here. Regarding the sampling, you should note that the sampling algorithm used by Kijai is slightly different from the standard Wan model. The number of steps is 4, so the speed is very fast. After decoding, you can see that the effect is very obvious. Let's compare it first. Let's bring in the original video.
Hey everyone, are you ready for something truly amazing? Because I found something that's completely changed my routine, and I know it's gonna change yours too.
Did you notice that the performance is excellent? Whether it is the movements, the facial expressions, or the consistency of the character. Of course, Kijai maintained his previous style by placing our reference image here. So, he has this video. In this video, you can observe a clear enhancement in consistency and accuracy in motion transfer. You can meticulously observe every lip movement, every action, and every expression. They are all very detailed. Moreover, the aesthetic quality is also excellent. Next, let's conduct another test. This video is relatively complex. Note that the original video looks like this. The camera starts underwater and slowly moves upwards. There is a beautiful woman standing underwater. So, the camera moves from her feet and legs up to her whole body and finally to her face. There are many elements involved here, such as reflections and the separation of the character between underwater and above water. This is actually a challenge for the model. Let's look at the result first. Everyone, look, the result is fantastic. At least regarding the final result, it actually meets our requirements for character transfer, whether it is the accuracy, the texture of the image, the character consistency, or the overall aesthetic appeal. I think it is all excellent. However, you can still spot some issues during this process, especially concerning the mask processing. Pay attention, the reflection was clearly not handled, right? And there are discontinuities in the middle. Note that as the camera moves up through the water, the reflection part was not included in the mask. And when the camera cuts above the water surface, the reflection is still not included in the mask. So, to be precise, the reflection part still belongs to the original character, not the final rendered character. But if we don't look closely, you might not notice this problem. Therefore, it is generally sufficient, and the quality is very high. Let's look at the third example. The third is a traditional vertical video, meaning we change the resolution to 400x832. This video is essentially a person dancing. Let's look at the transfer effect. Take a look, the consistency of the entire character, the transfer of expressions even though the facial resolution is relatively small. You can still see that the smiling expression was transferred very well. Through the testing of these three examples, you will find that the VSC version indeed shows improvements in overall effect and sampling speed. Now, some might ask if it has any problems. There are still issues though, I wouldn't call them problems, but rather drawbacks or shortcomings, for example. Look at this case. Our original video is actually a conversation between a man and a woman. Note that this is a vertical video because this node does not display according to the resolution we specified. What you see appears to be a horizontal screen. It should actually look like this. If we run this workflow now without any special settings, you will find that it replaces the first character. Let's look at the replacement effect. Let's synchronize it.
AI transforms businesses with faster data analysis and smarter decisions.
Well, the replacement effect itself is fine. However, the problem is that when using this workflow, you cannot specify exactly which character you want to replace. By default, it replaces the first character from left to right, top to bottom. Therefore, there is a special note here stating that if this does not meet your requirements, you can still use the point editor method we mentioned before to construct your mask. In multi-character situations, especially if the character you want to replace is not the first one from left to right, this workflow might still need to rely on the previous version. That means using red and green dots to mark the actual character you want to replace, then generating the mask, and finally achieving the perfect replacement. Okay, so that is the second version of Wan Animate that we introduced today. We didn't conduct extensive instance testing because we firmly believe it must inherit all the capabilities of the VF version. Therefore, we only provided explanations regarding its quality, speed, and shortcomings. You are welcome to try it out yourself. That is all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.